Well, I'm Harlan Bean, and this is Bean's Maple Distillery. It's not a sugar house or sugar shack, it's a distillery. We tap about, on a normal year, we tap about 2,500 taps, 2,500 maple trees. And from that, we produce anywhere between 600 and 900 gallons of syrup a year. Most of our lines, we use pipeline mostly. We don't have any buckets out this year, although we've had them out in the past. But so most of our lines are on our property. Of the 2,500, probably 2,000 of our or so are on our property, and 500 are on neighbors and other people's property. It's a pretty simple task. It depends. We need the warm days like today, but we need freezing nights. Ideal temperatures for us are 25 at night, 45 during the day. And from each tap, we hope to get a gallon of sap every day. So 2,500 taps, on a good day we get 2,500 gallons of sap. We've had a few good runs this year where we've gotten over 3,000 gallons per day. And you know, some days we get none or just a couple hundred. So most of my lines are on vacuum. It's a vacuum system that's actually sucking the sap out of the tree. We put a few less taps in, and by using the vacuum system, I don't need perfect temperatures. If it doesn't freeze at night, I can still get some sap from the trees. It doesn't hurt the trees at all. It's just like if you cut a tree and, you know, the sap dribbles out of it a little bit, it still heals back over and it's fine. So we have two big tanks. One is my main line, which is down off Conway Road, and we'll go collect that every day. And then I have another one up here. It's also on Conway Road, but up towards Poplar Hill. We'll go collect that, and then when we have enough syrup or enough sap, we'll start boiling. We've been doing sap and syrup for years, generations in the family, but we built this sugar house in 1987. And everybody has, you know, a sugar shack or a sugar house, and he wanted something different. So he decided to call it Bean's Maple Distillery. And it's kind of catchy and whatnot, but it's the same exact thing as a sugar house. We do the same exact thing. But that's pretty much it. We used to set a lot of buckets. Back when I was a kid, we'd set about 600 buckets, and we collect them all with oxen. I still have oxen, but I don't use them to collect the sap anymore. And we go through quite a process. When the syrup comes in, we hope to have at least 2.0% sap. That means there's 2% is sugar. This year it's been pretty good. We've had some 2.2% sap come in, and right now it's dropping as the year gets later. The sugar content drops. Right now we're about 1.6-1.7%, which means it takes many, many more gallons to make 1 gallon of syrup. Earlier in the year it was taking just under 40 gallons of sap to make 1 gallon of syrup. Right now it's taking all, you know, closer to 50 gallons of sap to make 1 gallon of syrup. We bring it in here right from the tanks. It goes through a filter process where we filter the sap, then we run it through a reverse osmosis machine, which we can take that 2% sap, run it through the osmosis machine, and turn it into 12% sap. And that allows us to boil it a lot faster. We use much less fuel. I burn with oil. We used to burn with wood, and we'd go through about 30 to 35 cords of wood a year. And when my father was alive, he cut all that by hand throughout the year, cut it, stacked it, split it. But as he got a little bit older, that was a little bit much, doing 35 cord of wood a year. So we decided to go to oil. And you know, having that reverse osmosis machine really cuts down how much oil we use. It also cuts down our boiling time. We can boil with this rig here about 250 to 260 gallons an hour. That's gallons of sap. So, you know, before we had the reverse osmosis, if we had 2,500 gallons, that meant we were boiling for 10 hours straight. Now we can turn that 2,500 gallons into about 600 gallons and boil it in 2 hours. So the reverse osmosis saves us a lot. Why don't you come out back here and we'll start out back. So our sap, our raw sap comes in from the trucks when we go to collect it, comes into this tank here. Then we'll run it through that pool filter and up into that real big holding tank. And we don't like to let the sap sit very long. It's got sugar in it, so obviously with warm temperatures, it'll start to spoil. So we like, when we get the sap, we like to boil it as fresh as we can, same day, if we can do that. So then once it's in there, that tank holds about 1,800 gallons. Once it's in there, it comes through here. So this is my reverse osmosis machine, and that sap, that 2% sap is coming in here, and it's getting squeezed down, I call it, to concentrated sap. So now we have, that's concentrated sap, and that is what we call permeate. It's the clean water. It's the reverse osmosis takes out the sugar water and the clean water. We use that clean water for cleaning up. And this is my vacuum pump. This is what's sucking the sap out of the trees. So that sap is coming in that top line. What it does is, the key to making good syrup is to have fresh sap daily, as cold as you can get it and as soon as you can get it boiled. And you want to cook it, you want to boil it as fast as you can. Get it from sap form to syrup form. So it comes in here and it's preheated. This steam from this, the evaporation, is preheating our sap. Then it enters into this unit here, and this is what we call, this is our steam pan. And if you can hear, that's an air blower in the back. We're injecting air into it. The sap in here is about 200 to 210 degrees. Not hot enough to boil, but by injecting the air into it, we give it a false boil so it evaporates more. Then it comes down into our big pan, which is doing the most of the work, and there's flues in here. The sap is coming in here, and it travels all the way down, all the way back. Then it enters into this front pan. As it goes through each tray, it's more and more concentrated. This is almost syrup there. When it reaches a temperature close to 219 degrees, which it's close right here, we draw it off. So we do it manually. Some guys have automatic draw off machines. I prefer to do it manually. I don't know why, call me old fashioned or just plain old slow, but this batch is ready. So we'll take about 2 gallons off at a time. Today we're making dark syrup, or what's called robust. It's grade A. The old system would call it dark amber. The new system, which is universal now throughout the United States, it's grade A dark robust. And that's probably our most popular syrup. And now that it's syrup, we'll run it through its first filter process. And usually I spill some so I get to lick my fingers, but. So when this finishing unit, we call it, when it gets full, it holds about 80 gallons. When it gets full, we'll put it through filter it under pressure through the filter press, and either we'll bottle it in jugs for sale, retail sale, or we'll put it in 15 gallon stainless kegs or 40 gallon stainless steel drums. And from that point, the process of making our syrup is done. Then we clean up and wait till next year.